Hey there everyone, good night, or well, for most of you probably still a good day. Hope you're all doing well. Really good to see you guys again. Ed, of course, that Dutch guy, the Pirate Gamer 12, and hey Austin, awesome to see you, man. And for Patchy, there's Griso. let's hope they like each other, huh? Yeah, so today I want to do some CDI stuff. My beer of choice today is a Cobra, which is an English beer. And yeah, this beer is very hoppy. Yeah, I'm trying now to also stream to Twitch. I don't know if everything works. I saw in the chat that it was telling us who's going to join the chat. I didn't really intend to do that, so sorry about that. I hope I have resolved that, but we'll see. I keep saying this, and I probably will do that a couple of more times as we stream. I have no clue what the heck I'm doing. We're just learning as we go. Anyway, so basically today is more or less kind of how Twitch works, and if that works fine. There are still a lot of emoticons in the chat coming into the stream. I have no clue how to solve that. They keep doing it. I've turned off all the emotes, but they keep popping up, and at least now the thing is actually reading what is said, so you know, at least I can hear what you're saying. So today, CDI. Now there's of course a lot of CDI stuff. I didn't want to make, I'm not going to play through an entire game. I think what is actually kind of interesting to go through the first game I ever covered in a video. And well, it's not actually a game, it's just a CD. And hey there, man. Good to see you. And this is the highlights disc for CDI Games. And if you search on my YouTube channel, you will not be able to find it. But I promise you, it's still online. But I'm not going to tell you because it's very embarrassing. But that was the first video I ever did. And it was with this disc. And it's just a highlight of different games. It's like a demo disc from CDI back in the day, so it's kind of cool. Hey there, man, great to see you around. Stay there, you Goomba. So let's just have a little go, see how things work out, and I should remember which button was it. I think this one, and we should start it up. Hey there, Ben, good to see you. Yeah, it was my first video. I think it was in February of 2008. And yeah, this is not my least favorite. This is, you know, it's a good model, but it works. It works. Anyway, this is just a bunch of videos basically, so this also gives you a bit of an impression what video CDs are actually like on this console. Although, having said that, the video quality in this one, ironically, is really, really, really bad. And yeah, so this is a video CD. It has just a bunch of demos of different games. So yeah, let's just let's just have a go here. Yeah, the VCDs basically all used this menu on CDI, I think. Please also let me know if the audio levels are correct or if I need to adjust something. And now is of course the question, can you name all the games that are displayed here? And that's gonna be difficult because a few of these never even came out. And yeah, it's really corny music. about a kiss for luck. Can't have that. Even Phillips themselves were pooping. And yeah, this was really one of the first demo discs I ever owned. I mean, this came out before I had the PlayStation. And I didn't have a CD drive in my PC back then, so, you know, this was really cool. But the video quality of this video CD is particularly bad, which is just weird to me. But, you know, it is what it is. Hey there, Rocket Gamer. Really cool to see you too in here. Thank you very much for joining us. Had enough? We don't think so. Phillips is really boasting about these games. Yeah, correct. Microcosm. Good pick there. Because that indeed, it was planned for CDI. But it never came out, unfortunately. Would have been pretty cool.
These guys gotta feel some real pain! We'll make them scream!
Yeah. Hi there, Rocket Boy. I'm sorry, sometimes the speech synthesizer is just messing up usernames, so I have to sometimes get used to it. That little scene from The Apprentice also kind of looks like a beta version or something, because that color scene I don't think is actually in the game. You took a bad hit. Anyway guys, how are the audio levels like this? Am I understandable? Is the game still... can you still hear it? Well, the game is just a bunch of videos now. Yeah, plumbers don't wear ties, never came to CDI. I'm not sure if that's a good thing or a bad thing. I mean, I never actually played it, but from what I've seen, it's hilarious. If it's great games you want, Phillips Mania game delivers. You are Lieutenant Jessica, well, they kind of don't. Leader of the Ark's interception. This is also kind of interesting. I will shut up a bit so you can actually hear what he's saying. As the Keshran forces ready their next offensive against the Earth, you re-enlist in the 11th Squadron of the Silver Dragons, assigned to the Lunar Base.
The Orbital Defense Force assembles all of its combat units for the ultimate counterattack, with the purpose of destroying the Keshran flagship. Your unit is then transferred to the Earth's General Headquarters in a 20-story bunker, located just a block from the Empire State Building. In order to open the way to civilians repatriated from the lunar base to the General Headquarters of Manhattan, you have to fiercely fight the Keshran warriors that you find in and around the city. And after liberating the Manhattan area, your next missions await.
I have never actually played the MS-DOS version. I'm just going to talk now again because it's honestly not that interesting. But what is interesting is that after you are freed from the labyrinth, I think this is the only... I don't think this actually was a commercial or anything, and you know, there was no game trailers yet. So it seems like kind of a unique thing, and this is also kind of weird because you have a video CD, Lemmings has this pretty cool animated cutscene at the beginning of the game, and they don't actually show it, they just show stills. It's just weird. But Lemmings has a pretty good port on CDI. If I remember correctly, you can actually pause and give the Lemmings tasks. And here's Creature Shock, one of the earlier games that went style over substance. I'm not an expert on... I think I only booted it up once or something, but that's nice visuals, but when it comes to actual gameplay, it's kind of lacking. But it looked cool back then, so you know, that was important. Of course, these graphics don't hold up that much, and this is also really interesting because this game actually looks really good, doesn't it? Now, of course, it's trickery because it's actually an FMV which you're seeing here, which is much like Chaos Control, where you also have a FMV where you have some moving elements on top of it. But this game, unfortunately, dead end, never came out. And here we have Thunder in Paradise. Recently did a video on it. And I don't know, I kinda enjoy it. I mean, it's not great. And the story is just total whack. But that's kind of interesting in these FMV games too, you know. This is key spoiled to an absolute maximum. But yeah, the game itself is actually fine for what it is. Yeah, the Terminator. And Ed, I really need to hand it to you. You did such an amazing job in editing the video. Thank you so much for that. That really was amazing. Yeah, there's that big dude. Once he shows up, you're in big trouble if that dude shows up. Funnily enough, the enemy placement is totally random, so you can have a run where he doesn't show up ever. And yeah, everyone seems to assume nowadays that you can't beat that little shoot 'em up, but you can. And yeah, of course I had to put this in. But, you know, these were the guys behind Baywatch, so what do you expect? I have no clue how Twitch works, so I hope it works well and that the bitrate is not too high for Twitch or too low. I don't know. I really need to experiment with Twitch. Yeah, that's the cool thing when you edit videos, you get to see all the different scenes. And yeah, we had a lot of extra stuff in this one. Because it's all video material. Great to hear that the stream is actually working on Twitch. How is it? How's on YouTube side for those watching there? Is the stream working good, or is it still cutting out because we had that issue before? Which I hope is not the case this time. Yeah, they don't put Zach in the seat here at all to talk, so that's pretty much a good thing. The blinking health indicator is actually kind of interesting, come to think of it, because that's not in the game at all. I guess they use cheats here. Who knows? Maybe there's still some in the game we haven't found yet. Well, it's pretty easy once you know what you're doing. You can't lose. Well, kinda, but not really. It's kind of cool that the actual episode is also on the VCD, except in territories where you don't have it. for some reason, I think it was a licensing issue.
It is the future.
But yeah, it's nice to have the VCD and you actually compare it with the actual game, and you see how much you're actually missing when you play Thunder in Paradise. Actually, the story when you just play the game, it makes no sense. And this game is, of course, one of the greats of CDI, Burn Cycle, awesome game. And because of this really oddball cyberpunk style, it still holds up quite well, I find, to this day. I mean, it's a lot of style, but it still works. I don't know if there's actually a repeat function, but I'm pretty sure that there was.
He's stolen more than he bargained for.
That these that this game would load in video stores, yeah. And yeah, Rocket Boy, I saw that little cheat menu you managed to figure in here, and that's really awesome, really amazing to that you're able to do that. And you know, it's fun to jump around in the game and explore different parts of it. Burn Cycle is such a cool little run. It's really, if you have the game on either MS-DOS or CDI, then yeah, definitely check it out. It's a blast to play through and just get through the story. And as I said, this style, it still holds up today, I find. It's not, I mean, yeah, it's obvious green screens, but, you know, it's cool. Yeah, well, I don't know, man. Burn Cycle seems to run a lot better than when Cyberpunk came out. And this is also kind of behind the scenes, the bane of my channel, I suppose. Yeah, most of the conversions from CDI to PC MS-DOS are basically the exact same game, but yeah, they tend to lack slightly in the presentation department, although normally it doesn't really matter too much. And I'm actually, when looking at this, I'm actually amazed how much worse this actually works compared to the actual games. And Little Devil is quite a cool game as well, but my goodness. Yeah, and we will get to it sometimes, but when you go through Little Devil and things mess up, you don't really feel like going through it again. It's such an amazing game in the sense of the presentation, but not for gameplay. It's rather frustrating. Yeah, there is a version for Thunder in Paradise on MS-DOS, isn't there? I've never actually seen that in action. So I don't really know, but I've seen it listed, some people mentioned it, and yeah, I've never actually seen it. Yeah, this one too, by the way. But the Seventh Guest is an amazing port for CDI. They did cut out, was it one or two puzzles, which is a shame. But otherwise, it has awesome music, great presentation. And this is also a really, really good port of this game. If you are in the McCree series or Lightgun games in general, then this is an amazing port, still also to this day. Partly because the Peacekeeper, the CDI's light gun, actually can work with modern TVs. Philips was really ahead of that. It's kind of funny because Nintendo actually got into a patent issue when they released the Wii and the Wiimote, because it's kind of like the light gun of the CDI, and I think that had something to do with their whole lawsuit they got involved in, and I think they settled out of court, but yeah, they paid some money to Philips for that. And of course, The Apprentice. Really fun little platformer game. Like, if you compare it to some absolute classic SNES platformers, then yeah, it's not that great, but on its own on CDI, it's an amazing game. And this one, I've been trying long and hard to actually find a English copy for reviewing this one, but I cannot find one. I've bought a couple of copies, and they all turn out being Dutch, damn it. But this is an interesting kind of strategy game. I never really got good at it. But, you know, it's kind of interesting because there are so few strategy games or in general on the CDI. Yeah, the Apprentice is my biggest lure of new viewers to the channel with the whole Nudalities thing. I think I was actually the first one who showed that in video form on YouTube, so, you know, that... It still gets in a lot of views and people are still amazed by it. Partly because it's not taken down, but you know. YouTube YouTube is fine with showing some skin as long as you don't monetize it, you know, and you know, appropriate label it. And yeah, Earth Command has a lot of climate change things in it, but you know, is climate change really a new thing? Because we had that in the 80s too, although then we were still afraid that we might freeze over. But you know, climate change has always been an issue and something that there was some attention for. So yeah, Philips was kind of ahead in, you know, putting more focus on it.
You and your friends can play one of 12 stories and choose from the classics.
And I think that's actually a good way to do it, you know, do it in a game form where people actually just have fun in a game and make people think about the actual world and where it's going. That's better than just telling them what they should think. Just allow them to think for themselves.
Select the murderer and weapon, and then hope for the best. Cluedo is the best interactive.
And this is also something that oh my goodness, this one is this next one, Caesar's World of Boxing, was also a game I planned on reviewing. I still think I have a lot of the footage. So you know, that probably still is coming, but that was when I kind of dropped out. This was the last review I was actually working on and never finished, unfortunately. But board games on CDI, actually a really good fit for the system. There's a lot of good renditions of board games and they are a lot of fun, although you know, it's something you need to be in the mood for, but when you are with a couple of people, yeah, CDI has got you covered with some cool renditions of board games and game shows. Really cool stuff, honestly. And of course, we've got Space Ace, which is also really cool. I tend to like Space Ace a bit more than Dragon's Lair. But that's also because it's a bit easier for me, because there is a linear path.
Dragon's Lair, the fantasy adventure.
And here we have the original, of course, which is still, you know, it still looks amazing. And it's kind of the cool thing of these games as well. They just hold up so well because, well, it's just hand-drawn animation. And it always looks good. And, well,
in the mysterious caverns below the castle, your odyssey continues.
You know, if you're not animation magic, then hand-drawn graphics look great. Road Invention is cool, but unfortunately never came out on the CDI, so it don't count, no. But yeah, Road Invention is a game that I would love to play because it looks like a lot of fun. And this is a sequel to Dragon's Lair. Is it a CDI exclusive? I think it might be. And this game is total whack. This game is just so out there with its situations it presents you with. It's complete madness. It's kind of interesting. Another cool FMV game like this is actually Braindead 13. Ah, it's on the Jaguar. Ah, I didn't know.
The year is,
and there is this game, which is cool, but it's animation magic. Although in this game, animation magic isn't as bad as in the Zelda games, to be honest. But Mutant Rampage is a pretty cool game, I find. And I actually have it here, so we could have a go at it in just a bit.
Bioengineers have created animal-human hybrids. Athletes.
Yeah, this doesn't lend itself too well for YouTube poop. I mean, it's still corny and all that, but the actual animation, they really improved it over the Zelda games and Mario games here. It's also funny that like every bad animation on CDI is attributed to animation magic, even though they didn't make that many games. Or I'm actually going to skip this one because, you know, we can play this in just a bit. And that was actually the last part. So How about we are starting to play an actual game? And how about some Tetris? One of my favorite games on CDI, actually. Just have a bit of a, you know. Where did I put the thing? Where did ah, there we go. And the Pirate Gamer 12, you mentioned the wacky world of miniature golf. Unfortunately, I lost that game. It's such a stupid game, but also kind of fun. Especially when with others. But yeah, now we are going to play some Tetris here, which this music, you know, if you're into some meditation, just put it on and lie down and drift off to the higher spheres. There's the monolith. Not sure why they chose that. This is from the wacky time where everyone was basically making a Tetris version. This is not my favorite Tetris version, but it's a solid pick on CDI, that's for sure. And maybe we'll see the dog. yeah, and for options, it's kind of barren. You can have a height. You can also not show the next piece, which. Anyway, let's actually try that. See this. Yeah, 2000 Space Odyssey started with the monolith, and you know, it's a cool thing to actually you know, reference. I keep pressing down, but it doesn't work in this version. I don't have any bots set up at the moment. So yeah, I wanna now. Yeah. I hope that we can get rid of the bots, and unfortunately, you know, there's always gonna be some spammers. Thank you very much for blocking them. Yeah, the backgrounds. This is such a weird ass game, because you know, as you get higher, you get more panicky, but the backgrounds are actually, you know, so soothing, so relaxing. So there's a bit of clash of feelings eventually. Yeah, so you only have instant drop, and it's kind of difficult because you cannot, like, there's no lines, so you really have to align it by sight, which is usually the part where I get tripped up the most, where you just drop it right next to a part. It's kind of interesting because I never play it without showing the next block, but this is actually kind of an interesting way to play Tetris. Kind of cool to try it out like this. Oh boy. Yeah, a behind the scenes of this game would actually be kind of interesting, because it's just such a curious game. Like, why did they go for this art style? On the one hand, you had Philips like pushing so hard to show that they were like the cool kids for gaming, and then they come with a Tetris version that is just like totally mellow. I love Tetris in general as a puzzle game, because it is like it really emphasizes like the possibility of correcting an error. Like if I mess up in columns, I'm dead pretty fast. I'm not good at columns, or Tetris Attack, for example. Those games are, I find, much harder. And perhaps that's just like practice? But I don't know. Yeah, this game does not use the DVC, and It does show in the background, but I don't find it too distracting that there's not too much going on. Like, you have the more intense Tetris versions, and it can really honestly get too messy and just distract you all too much. And I don't have too many Tetris games, actually. Of course, the NES version is still a classic, love to play that now and then. And the version I actually enjoy the most is probably Tetris Plus. I have that on the PS1, and I enjoy that so much because there they have a puzzle mode that actually, you know, feels kind of different. And it's kind of different and just really fun to play. And it also has a solid classic mode, so, you know. But yeah, you can't really go wrong with Tetris now, can you? I know some developers went wrong with it, but honestly. And yeah, this I did rip this music some time ago, and I'm not sure if it's still available on... I did put it on my Google Drive. But I highly recommend you checking out the music, because it's just such an amazing track. Don't put it up when you're actually going for a workout though, because that won't work. And yeah, you really need to get used to the drop. But it's possible, it's not too big of a deal. I mean, I haven't messed up yet, I think. I mean, perhaps you didn't agree with some of the... And of course, just as I say that! Oh my goodness. But we can recover. Yeah, thank you. Thanks, Ben. But I deserve that. Yeah, indeed, Curse of the Commentator. But you know, what level did actually Doc pop up? The Tetris Doc. What kind of training video was that? Knitting competition? I mean, I don't think I would run long for on this music. Yeah, I think I heard something about that vinyl. Yeah, and people, you know, that's kind of the frustrating thing, that people still buy it. I mean, it's good music. It's nice that it's on the vinyl, but... Did they actually try to, you know, talk to the original composer? Yeah, I can't imagine why you would use something else for a training video. Or do you mean like training in general, not like sports? Because, of course, my mind goes to sports right away. I used to be a fitness trainer for just a bit. So, you know, it's what you think of first. Ah, well, that's a shame, you know. I would totally support a vinyl release of this game if at least the original composer is brought in as well. That would be cool. Yeah, instructional. Yeah, that makes more sense. Sorry about that. I'm just... Sometimes my brain thinks in strange ways. But, you know, that's part of being a brain, I suppose. And this really sucks, you know, here you can't push down to have it go further, you really have to just wait. But oh well, it is what it is. There's actually also another pause button, because button 1 and 2 also just plonks down the piece, so you cannot actually pause the game, which is, you know, kind of annoying. Someone is at the door, there goes your high score. And yeah, I won't be saving high scores because this CDI does not have the capability of saving games. Coming back to why I'm actually using this CDI. the 450, which does have a bit poorer video quality, is something I didn't know, but my other CDI, which I like to use, that one has kind of an issue with reading discs, so I need to get that fixed. And that's unfortunately. Really? Awesome. I did not know that, or I forgot. But you can pause. Really cool. I did not know that. Or I forgot, but cool. So now someone can actually come at the door. Oh no, I'm streaming. They can't. Which level had the dog? I forgot. Where's the Tetris dog? And yeah, if you're not knowing know what I'm talking about, there is a level where the video actually captures a dog walking by. And the funny thing was that back in the 90s, there was a Dutch CDI magazine which I was reading, and that was really quite... How should we put this nicely? But it was just crap. It was really bad journalism. It was mostly a fan club of CDI, and it really showed. But you know, there also were letters from readers that came in, and they... One of the readers wrote in like, "There's a dog! There's a dog! Why is there a dog?" Oops. And there came a whole discussion with follow-up letters and such on what is the dog, and the magazine actually went to Philips to ask what's with the dog. Is it a cheat code? Or no, it's just a video playing. it's always stuck with me, like they were making such a big deal out of it. This is bad. And it was really nothing at all. It was making a story out of thin air. But yeah, it's cool, you know, how those things work out. But they were making it out... Oh no! But they were making it out like... oh dear. Like it was like the next big secret in gaming, like it was the negative levels in Mario. Oh crap, I'm dead. Yeah, I'm dead. Oh well. Let's have a go again there. Oh, I can put in my name. Yay. Normally I'm better at recovering, but you know, it's not always. I'm not sure why I'm actually putting my name in, but oh well. I think... By the way, this button is totally useless. It basically, I think it is actually there to press, you know, to start a new game with the same options. But, you know, I didn't change it. And it just saved this fine. I think level 6 maybe. Let's just go to the next one. And if it's the doggo level, we actually get to see the doggo, perhaps. Or did we already pass it? No, this is the doggo level, so, you know, let's see if we can hold out long enough for him to show up. Or her, who knows? Okay, let's see. Yeah, I find it kind of interesting with the show next not displaying. It keeps you more focused, I find. Kind of an interesting way to play Tetris. I never tried it like that, but it's an interesting way. Now I need two of the long ones. That might not have been a smart move, but I'm not known for my smart moves. Yes, CDI has a lot of bare-bone games. And yeah, Connect 4 is a great example of that, where you just have, well, Connect 4, like, wow. A full game. And there was also, yay, 11 viewers, awesome. Thanks for the heads up. There was also like a Jigsaw game. It's kind of cool because Jigsaw on CDI is arguably Sony's first video game. I'm not sure if there's any more, but yeah, a lot of people don't realize, but CDI was also developed by in part by Sony. They dropped out just as it was getting released, but you know, technically speaking, CDI is also Sony's first video game console. Because I'm not sure if this is actually working. Oh, it does work. Cool. I think Twitch is a bit slow in refreshing view counts. Honestly, I don't really care too much about the view count. I'm just, you know, I'm just acting like 100 people are here, regardless of how many there are. You know, I need to train to be talkative too, so, you know. Which is an interesting thing. Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, there was a CDI device by Sony, so, you know, it was their first console, kind of. And that thing is really freaking hard to actually find. I don't have it. Would be awesome. Oh my goodness, a million. I'm so nervous now. Nah. Yes, I am. Of course, that had to go wrong right away. But we can still recover from this, I think. Did the dog actually get past us already? I don't know. I didn't really keep track of the background. And I shouldn't do that right now either. I'm not actually sure when the dog shows up, but he will eventually. Probably in the next game, if I keep it up like this. No. Oh boy. Yeah, we're doomed. Now, like when you're this high, it really starts to hurt that you do not see what piece is coming next. Oh no. Ah, okay, then it will pop out soon enough. On the right side. Just sniffing the beach there. yeah, I'm dead. Oh boy. Awesome. That was kind of bad. Sorry we didn't see the dog in full then. But yeah, it's kind of cool that the doggo is there and people would make such a big thing out of it. What Tetris versions do you like the most, guys? What are your favorite renditions of it? Should I go for... Let's try it again, but with some lines here. And let's show next. Like, what's your favorite Tetris version of them all? As I said, for me, it's probably Tetris Plus. Just a fun game. Also, really good music in that one. And as I said, just the whole puzzle mode in that, I really enjoyed. Such a cool game. Is it by Taito? Not entirely sure now. I think it was by Taito. Of course, had some other great puzzle games, like Puzzle Bubble, of course. I don't know that one, Pirate Boy. Never played Pet Tetris Splash either. My first Tetris was pretty sure... Oh crap, this was not the correct point here. My first Tetris was definitely the NES version, which I still enjoy quite a bit to this day. It's just so playable, you know? It's just pop it in and just have fun with it. Yeah, let's go a bit low because I'm not that good anymore. and you know, CDI, it does lack a bit in the control department, but honestly, it's just me. Tetris Effect also has a VR version, doesn't it? Looked kind of interesting, but I never tried it. I never tried the sequel to Tetris Plus, but the first one, a really awesome game. And yeah, the Puyo Puyo games, I kind of like them, but I'm really bad at them. Just, you know, you've got some of those puzzle games where you can't just get your head around it. Yeah, Tetris Effect, I think it's... I saw it and I was like, that might look a bit too distracting. Yeah, Dr. Robotnik's Mean Bean Machine, classic for sure. Again, not a style of game that I'm just good at. All those Puyo Puyo games, I just suck at them, unfortunately. But I still like to play them now and then and just have a go at it. Same goes for Columns. I am so bad at it. I can't chain for the life of me in that game. And it tends to speed up really quickly. A game I really do love, however, is Dr. Mario. I love Dr. Mario. And I used to be really good at it as well. Love to play that on the NES, but also on the Wii eShop, or what was it called? eShop? I don't know. But it had a version of online version of Dr. Mario, and that was so much fun. And I racked up quite a nice rating there. If you send six rows to your opponent, that would be pretty bad for the opponent. Not so much for you. That'd be kind of awesome, but yeah. I love those, like the competitive modes where you play head to head with someone. It's one of the games, like puzzle games. My mother actually loves to play those games, so I played a lot of Dr. Mario and Tetris and other such games. Yoshi's Cookie, another awesome puzzle game, I find. But yeah, I used to play those a ton with my mother. And my grandmother, actually. Oh, crap. I've only seen the first Sonic movie and it was okay. I mean, yeah, I enjoyed it. I mean, it wasn't spectacular or anything, but then it's a Sonic movie, so what do you expect? It was just a good popcorn flick. And I can appreciate movies for just that. Sometimes you just wanna have a bit of fun. Eat your popcorn. I don't actually like popcorn. Another hot take here. Especially not the sweet stuff, that's just disgusting, come on. I'm not sure why people tend to stuff their face with that. Sorry, Pirate Boy, the speech thing really messed... Oh, crap. I'm dead. Othello, yeah, Othello is another, you know, it's just a board game, and for board games, CGI is really good. Anyway, I think we had enough about me sucking. What's the first game? What's the best one? Yeah, go figure. I hate to plug my own stuff, but if you've never seen the sketch I did for Tetris, it's still a video I'm kind of proud of because it was just so much fun to do and it came out really cool. And yeah, that guy in the video is actually me. But yeah, Tetris for CDI, I love it. Awesome game. Really highly recommend you picking it up if you have the chance. It's not expensive, or, you know, CDI has no copy protection, so you can just burn the bastard and play it. I think this one also has a good chance of being emulated well. Not entirely sure. And it's also kind of interesting, you know, not all, but almost all CDI games have a credit sequence when you exit the disc. And for some reason, you kind of all also can just open the disc drive. But no one did that because that would hurt the disc back then, you thought. But of course, that's not true. Yeah, my videos first appeared on RetroWare TV, yeah. I wasn't official part of the site because, you know, I wasn't good enough for it. But they had a little section like of people sending in stuff, and my videos got introduced there first. And then I moved on and just kept it to the YouTube channel, and you know, it's cool. Just before it was saying that I couldn't show it publicly because Philips might sue me. You know, they need some money because they have been recently been killing some people in the US with their what's it called in English? Upno as well? Devices. I think CDI porting is really difficult because making something on CDI is pretty hard already because it's just such a finicky little system to actually deal with. As I understand it, I mean, I'm not much of a programmer myself. I got only rudimentary far in Java, C++, and, you know, I could type out or have the computer type out Hello World, but that's about it. Forgot all of that stuff. But yeah, as I hear, CDI is really challenging to develop for it, and the format of the CD is so different that I think it's rather difficult to just take a game for CDI and port it over, like backward engineer the thing. I was planning to do another review soon, and I did that before, but as you look at my older videos, they're really crappy, so I'm actually planning on doing some of the older reviews again, and one of which is, of course, where you have to start, family games. So how about we go through family games for a bit and, you know, just have some fun for those who have never seen it. Some fun at me sucking probably again for those who have seen it. And this way I can actually I should turn on the system, shouldn't I? I turned it off for some reason. I can actually show off or record some footage for the review. So, you know, two birds in one stone. And yeah, Family Games here came with the CDI 450, I think, as a pack-in game. Or, wait. No, Burn Cycle came with the 450. This one came with the earlier, and it's basically, well, mostly also kind of a demo disc. What's kind of funny is that it's more involved than many of the actual released games. It has 10 full games, and because it has 10 games, it's actually a decent package. Yeah, the Flintstones games, Time Warp is Ed, you're gonna see this a lot. The Flintstones games, Time Warp with the Jetsons, where they cross over, it's kind of cool in that way, and, you know, it's interesting as a bit of a click point and click game. It's very basic, it's mostly aimed towards children, but, you know, it's cool. The CDI has a lot of cool games as that as well. Anyway, we've got 10 games here. We have Full Attack, we have some Japanese game, which we will see the title of once we start it, and I don't remember it. What's that sound? Skid Card, Captain Alphabet, Draw Stamp Color, Super Slide, Mofon Invasion, Wizard, Hot Rocks, and the credits is not a game. The quality of these games varies wildly. And let's just go from the top and go... Well, this is probably the best game already, right away. And it's kinda cool. I'd never beaten it, that's the annoying part, so maybe today is the day. I wouldn't keep a fingers crossed on that one. But Full Attack is a shoot 'em up. And it's a really basic shoot 'em up because we are dealing with the CDI. What it does have is a really nice presentation, I find. I'm going to play on Rocky. After this run, I will show you why. But you know, we just want to showcase the actual levels. And the music is also really kind of interesting. It's kind of cool music. Anyway, we are this ship here, and we can shoot a laser. And this might look a bit choppy, I am sorry about that, but my CDI runs at 50 Hz. And unfortunately YouTube doesn't like 50 frames per second when streaming. I'm not sure if Twitch does better with that. So anyway, the output is set to 60 frames per second, so you got a bit of choppiness when fluid games like this, which is kind of annoying. Anyway, you just go about, shoot a bunch of stuff on the screen. There's no sound effects. Unfortunately, that is a drawback of CDI. But this game really has a really cool presentation, I find. Like, look at the backgrounds. It's so cool. And... does it? I seem to remember that someone pointed out to me that YouTube did not like 50 frames per second when streaming. It would just up it to 60 frames per second anyway. And yeah, the music in this is actually really cool, I find. And what's kind of interesting is this game is this game is only having 4 levels, but the levels are quite hard, and when you die you have to start all the way back to the beginning, so you know, it can be a bit frustrating in that regard because the levels go on quite long. And yeah, the stream is set to 60 frames per second. That is basically because I was under the impression that YouTube doesn't allow streaming at 50, but I can try it next time. And what is kind of interesting when looking at the CDI's capabilities, oh boy, the CDI is really bad at sprite work. Oh boy, concentrating. But it can have giant bitmaps as backgrounds, and basically this is a giant image where we're just flying through now. And you know, the drawback is that you don't have very fast-paced hectic shooters, but the upside is that you can actually have really detailed backgrounds, and they look absolutely fantastic. The lamp is next to life, so that's cool, so we can die freely right now. I think we should be coming up to the ending here, and I'm kind of impressed with myself that we went through here. But there's still the boss! Sorry. Out of lunch. Yeah, Samurai Showdown is not gonna work on CDI. The best you get is Rise of the Robots. And that's the best in heavy, heavy quotations. And I guess Shaolin Road also has a fighting section. And this music track has, for some reason, an epic guitar riff. For some reason they felt they needed to put it in there. I hope I can reach it. Ooh, I'm not sure if that was almost deaf. Sometimes it's a bit hard to figure out what is background and what is not. And level 2, I should watch out because I should watch out what I say, but usually I have an easier time with the second level. But you know how that goes. I can crash any moment now. Shaolin Road is a rough game, man. It's rough. Especially if you're not playing on the easiest difficulty. At which point you can't get the good ending. I think. That's how it goes, right? Just like a practice session, the white belt. There's also Shaolin's Road on the Commodore 64 Audio Arcade, which is much more fun. Hear this guitar riff. Like, why put that effort in there? Like, it sounds awesome, but it's just such an odd thing to include. Really cool though. Oh boy, almost crashed into that, which would be a shame because we are almost at the end. And then we get to the level where I'm not going to get very far because the difficulty spikes up tremendously in the third stage, unfortunately. So I've never actually seen the fourth level. Yeah, I must admit the guitar riff, actually, once you get there, I'm like, okay, I can die now and go through that and be happy. Because you get to hear that again. It's just, someone has really went out of their way to make that. No, there's no parallax scrolling at all in this one. It might be possible on CDI, I'm not entirely sure. Are there parallel scrolling? Oh no! Oh wow, you can actually fly through there. Is there actually a level of games that have parallel scrolling? I think there are actually, but I can't think of one right now. Hey there, Ginger Hippie Gaming, great to see you here. This is Full Attack, which is on the Family Games Numero Unos, which is a kind of a demo disc for the CDI that came with your giant ass paperweight. And this is probably the best game on the whole collection. But yeah, this also came with my CDI, come to think of it, and we got a... Ah, crap. We got a CDI 220 as our first system. I think about half my father's monthly income went to a system. And let's try this. This level is just brutal, man. This is just... I don't know, man. I kind of dig Laser Lords. But mostly for its corny thing. It's kind of unique. Kind of puzzle game. Another game that... Oh, really? That hit me? Another game that I only recently actually finally found an English copy of. Yeah, the CDI 450 is the one I'm using now, which is an excellent CDI system. It's more... It's kind of funny because it was more marketed as a game console. Although it's also the one console where they decided to remove the second input port. It's just like a bit of an oddity there. Let's see if I can get slightly further now. Nope. There's also, in this game, there's no... Like, the CDI has this switch where you can adjust the cursor movement. That has no effect on this game. Which kind of makes sense, but you'd be surprised how many games don't get that, actually. But yeah, this is really an early game, so it's not complex in any way. It's not pulling on out any interesting tricks or anything. But still, as a demo piece, this game is really impressive just for the background and just the style. Like, I don't know, it's kind of a guilty pleasure for me, this game. Although I would like to, at one point in my life, actually see the fourth level. But I don't think that's going to happen this time, guys. I did occasionally get slightly further. Oh my goodness. Can you go to the top there? Let's try that. Last life. You can... Like when you go further, it there's a bunch of green crystals eventually, and then, you know, you get more very tight corridors, and it's just super difficult. Thank you, Ed. you are actually editor on. There we go. You are actually editor on Twitch, I think. So, oh, crap, not the same thing. Yeah, those timekeepers, man, they are problematic. I only have one CDI where the timekeeper battery is replaced. I did buy a bunch of sockets to get another bunch done. Hopefully my father can do that. I'm sure he can do it. He just needs to find time for it. And then we have a bunch of actually working CDIs. And, you know, might be cool to make another giveaway again for a working CDI system that is fully working. Anyway, let's try out what it does when you actually up the difficulty, because this time the enemies shoot. But look at the size of those bloody... Wait to fly right into it. Look at the size of those bullets. Honestly, these are way too tiny for me to keep track of, and the game is already hard enough on just the rookie difficulty, so rookie difficulty, so I just never try this because it's just too difficult. And yeah, especially on the lighter big rounds like here, I can barely see it, but I need to pay so much attention to it. Yeah, this is just a bit too hard for me. And they can shoot through walls, I think. Kinda crap. Yeah, if you can find that PCI card, you are indeed rich. I don't know if I would actually classify it as the Holy Grail of CDI. But it is very, very rare. But there's a bunch of CDI devices in general that are just really, really hard to find. Or consoles in particular. There's also a bunch of off-brand consoles that are just impossible to find nearly. Everyone who's gone into the world of CDI knows of Philips. Making a TV with a player integrated. But you also have, for example, other TV. I think it was a German brand I once saw at a friend's house who actually managed to pick one up. And it was not Philips branded, it was a TV from, I think it was 2002. And it allowed you to play back CDI. It had an integrated CD player with CD capability, and I think also DVD. It was just such a bizarre thing. I never seen it since. And yeah, CDI is just a lot of really strange stuff like that. That the TV came out. That was in 2000. I think that was in 2002. And you know. Not many people know this, but even in the 2000s there were still some CDI titles made. Yeah, that was bound to happen. But mostly in a corporate setting. Like for training purposes, CDI was really good. So in corporate settings, CDI was still being used and some titles were still produced. Although those are near impossible to find nowadays, unfortunately. And you got a lot of fun little gadgets for CDI. I wanted to exit. For example, for the CDI 450, there is also a infrared sensor you can buy separately. There is also... There's also a splitter, also useful for the 450, so you can actually use two controllers for the, what is it, two free games that actually allow you to play head-to-head. And yeah, CDI is kind of cool because there's still quite often a discovery made of some, you know, rare finds. Anyway, let's check out this game, which is also kind of interesting in a conceptual way, but also really, really boring in another. Ah, yeah, The Adventures of Yuki-chan. That's the one. This is kind of an adventure game. Kinda looks like it wants to be a Zelda game, but it's definitely not. Can we start? Ah, there we go. Yeah. And let's see if we can actually get through here. It's not very hard. But yeah, you can walk into the water, you die. And you collect stuff for points, of course you do. Or actually you don't. No, you collect fruit for health. That's the one. There's no point system in this game. And there is stars, which are also health, I do believe. Did I already forget a key? Of course I did. This is proving to be a great... Oh crap, where am I? There I am. Get through the bloody... Go through the bloody door, man. And yeah, now we've got this assassin dude shooting us. And we can take care of him. Whoop. There we go. Yeah, this... It's kind of funny, you know, because a lot of these games actually have a point system and it makes no sense. Like, family in generally is kind of debatable. Like, what do you think of a family game? Does this look like a family game? It's an adventure game. I guess what they were going for was like, there's games on here that the whole family can enjoy. I can't go through here. Yeah, I don't know the actual ouch route at all, so, you know, bear with me. Ah, you bastard. Yeah, I can't avoid this one. But luckily there's some food here to replenish us slightly. Just you wait when I get the gun, buddy. You'll be so dead. And yeah, as you can see, this is just really a basic, basic game here. With a lot of stuck sound effects. Nope, this is not Chip's Challenge. Kind of looks almost like it. It would be cool. It's a better game than this one. I think the yin yang symbol is an extra life. I'm not entirely sure. But yeah, it's just a very basic game. But again, what kind of is showing? Well, should you call it power? I don't know, but. The one thing CDI can do is just make this giant map, and we are actually, we are playing on a giant map here. Yeah, I forgot the geishas. You need to collect all the women. How about this sound? I'm not sure what he's doing to these poor geishas, but apparently he's saving them. He's saving them, guys. Not sure how to interpret that saving. Yeah, me either. It's just like you had a bunch of. Did I forget another bloody thing? I did. You have all these stock sounds to choose from, and you choose that one when saving the damsel in distress. That just why? Was someone on the developing crew trolling that day? Surely there are better sound effects. Surely. Anyway, let's move on. And again, guys, sound effects coming. Oh crap, I actually died. Oh no, no checkpoint yet. Is the sound actually coming through okay? Are the sound levels all right? Is what I intended to say. And I know I asked this before, but you know, it tends to change when we change games now and then. Let's make our way back there. This is a really tedious game. Alright, thank you, Pirate Gamer Boy, thank you. Thank you, Daniel, good to know. And I hope I am pronouncing the names correctly. I sometimes the speech synthesizer kind of messes things up, and I'm like, what? Who's talking? Great. Always good to check. Yeah, CDI is capable of producing really good sounds. I think the issue here is that they just use cheap stock sounds. Which, you know, was kind of a common practice still, because digital sound in general was still a new thing. So having any kind of sound that wasn't just samples was... Bam. Now playing has changed. I have tried Power Hitter, and calling that a baseball game is really a stretch. Funny thing, my cousin was quite into baseball, like playing it. He was quite good, so of course he got the baseball game on CDI, and we were quite shocked to see that you barely play any baseball at all. I haven't played it in years. Last time I played it was pretty much with him, which probably was 1993 or something. I do have it. I did pick up a copy at some point. Finally, we find a checkpoint. And do remind me that there is another girl up there we need to collect. That sounds really bad. But you know what I mean. Get out of here, buddy. Where do I go? There's an invisible maze here, which is quite annoying, because those spikes, they are instant death, and that's crap. Kind of. The what's it called? Oh boy. Ah, there we go. I never tried putting a PlayStation disc in the CDI. But again, Sony did help develop the Philips CDI. So they took what they knew and what they learned from that experience and implemented that in the Sony PlayStation 1 as well. So, you know, you got things like audio that take heavy inspiration from it in working the same way. I was trying to avoid this, but yeah, you can actually walk through those flowers. I forgot. And it's just cool to see that. And yeah, it's also how I rip the music is through that that little tool, which is a really cool tool to rip PlayStation games, but also some items on the CDI. It doesn't work on all music. CDI had a few different ways of handling audio. Another one was, of course, just making like CD audio, Redbook audio. That's also a possibility, and that works, of course, also quite well. There was a special format for CDI actually called CDI Ready, where you can actually put the CDI game, oops, in the I lost my train of thought. I am sorry about it. But yeah, when it comes to graphics, it's really tricky, because almost all CDIs, as I understand it, kind of use different techniques, and you really have to go through a hex editor to find the correct addresses and find the right kind of way to deal with it. Come on, man. Where is the thing? Oh, no. Hey there, Austin. Good to see you on YouTube as well. I don't know what platform is better, honestly. I tend to prefer YouTube. But yeah, you know, it's always good to have different options, I find. And yeah, that music of Tetris does get stuck into your head, isn't it? But, you know, when it becomes nighttime, it's quite beneficial, I find. Ooh, almost walked into the spike, the spikes. Yeah, I'm just, like some people mentioned that, like, Twitch is their preferred way to view, especially on mobile, I think. Let's actually get rid of this dude here, because he's a bit of a pain in the ass. And, you know, it's just, it's there if people prefer it. I don't really care for monetization much, so, whoops. And I'm just, you know, YouTube will always be my primary platform I push, I suppose. But, you know, it's a little effort to use them both, as long, you know, it works. It's actually, I'm kind of curious, is there actually a watermark from Restream? Because I wasn't really clear if that was the case or not. But I figured, you know, I'm not going to pay for a service I haven't even tried out yet. So I figured I'd stick with the free model. Which also limits you to two platforms to stream on, but you know, I wasn't really planning to adding any more, so two is enough. I'm not actually sure if you can ever open those doors. Ah, damn it, there he is again. That would make things a lot easier, wouldn't it? There we go. Okay, that's good. Then I think Restream only adds a watermark when you actually use their studio to start a stream, but of course we use OBS, which is just such an amazing program nowadays. It's so handy for everything. I also do all my recordings with it. It's just great. Very versatile and flexible as well. You can do a lot of stuff with it, which of course I know pretty much nothing about for the most part. I think there it is. Secret walls, of course, there have to be secret walls. And these, I think there's actually 7 shards of the mirror, because, you know, you don't want bad luck, so might as well. It's not very inspired game, but, you know. You get what you get. Let's see. Yeah, I've used Camtasia in the past as well, and it kind of worked okay, Camtasia. Oh no, we need to backtrack later to get the green key first. And what was handy about Camtasia was that it could capture and edit your videos. Like OBS, it can't capture. It can capture, but it cannot edit videos, at least not yet. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised that eventually they add that as well. but then again, Camtasia in editing is kind of limited as well, so if you want to do actual editing, then it's probably best to use another program generally anyway. I use Premiere, it's good. It's kind of hefty though, and not very cheap, bloody hell. but I also, you know, really like Audition, that's the one from Adobe. Adobe is just great when you have a couple of programs that can work together, that they work together so well. Oh no, I forgot something, but I don't know where it is. Ah, damn it, I don't know. I forgot something. And I don't know where it is. This is just bad. I'm actually going to skip to the next game because I don't know where it is. I don't want to wander on too much. But this one should open at some point. But I forgot to pull a switch or something. I don't know. Vegas, I never actually tried. It's really like what you try first that you stick with, right? Like, I actually started on Pinnacle Visual Studio. And I stopped using that because that thing kept crashing so much. It was such a pain in the ass. But still, you know, it worked in the early days. And then I switched over to Adobe Premiere, I think it was CS6 at that point. And I just stuck with it and started using other programs. At some point I would like to also learn a bit more about After Effects. Anyway, we are going to play Audio Memory. This is just such a basic game. And DaVinci Resolve is also a very good pick. It has a very robust... what's it called? Yeah, they're free version. I'm sorry, sometimes my brain just goes out for a bit. But yeah, this is just a very basic memory game. But on audio, which is kind of... it's kind of interesting, you know, doing audio version. So let's see what we can get. This is the music instruments version. Yeah. Already got four, so this is gonna be... Ah, this one we had. Was it this? No. Oh my god. Hey James, good to see you. Yeah, I'm not... I can't even blame this on being half blind. Because it's your ears that you need here. Choral video, that's an old thing. I only saw the choral photo editing suite, I think, ever. Never really dabbled much into it. There's another Adobe classic, of course. Photoshop, which I'm really terrible in using, but you know, it's so versatile. Oh my goodness, I'm so bad at this. This is the one, right? Yeah. Don't shout too hard at me. Oh no, which one was this? Oh my goodness. This is this one. Yeah. You know, this is kind of an interesting game, but what's lacking here is that if you play it with more people, the board's just way too small. I mean, I'm challenging, and I've enough of a challenge just by myself. Where's this from? I know it's from something, but I forgot. There we go. Did he know? And once you finish, you get to play again. But there's different soundscapes you can get. And now you get the what's this? Sci-fi sounds? Yeah, sci-fi sounds. There's also cartoon sounds, and I don't know, there's a whole bunch. Like, this kind of makes sense as a family game, and for just a demo disc, it's kind of neat. Oh, you actually need to click the door to exit. It's kind of neat, you know, it's there. It's not super, super interesting, but eh. Yeah, he was all over the place, wasn't he? Skid card, which is kind of a... I don't know, you decide. Is this a ripoff? Yeah, Name This Tune is also a game I would like to do a review from at some point. I will need someone from the US to give me a bit of a perspective on the game, because you know, that show actually never came out. But it, yeah, you need to abide by the honor system. It only makes sense if you play that with multiple people, because you get to see, say, if you got it right or not. So that game makes zero sense to play alone. Anyway, yeah, what does this remind you of, huh? It is kind of different, I suppose. You need to collect the flags. Some extra time is always good to have. And yeah, and collect as much or as many points as possible. Yeah, a lot of stores and cinemas used to have the CDI. Oh crap. Always with the chips challenge, yeah. I agree, Ed. But yeah, this does look. But this does look a lot like Rally X. It's slightly different, but you know, it's very clear where they found some inspiration from. Oh crap! Didn't want to pick up the negative time there. This game gets quite tough eventually, because now it's quite open, but later on the levels get more linear, and you know, you basically have to be very lucky and not get screwed over by the computer cars. Also worth noting is that the bar in the top, that element, is actually used by multiple games in the compilation. You know, it's just reused and slightly different. Full Attack also has the same thing as a base. And yeah, Arcade Classics could have had the Rally X game, I suppose, would have made sense. It's certainly a game that should run on CDI. Was Rally X? Was that a Konami game, actually? Namco, I'm sorry. Because I'm not entirely sure. Oh, no, get the flag, Zeb. Get the flag. We need two more. And I think this level actually forces you to go through a negative time. So, hopefully we have enough time. I think there's another hidden room here. Just in time to avoid that car there. And there is a flag there, so let's see. Okay. Oh crap. You cannot actually get rid of these bosses also, so you have to really avoid it. So in linear paths like this, it can be real tricky. Oh crap, I forgot that the exit is all the way to the other side, isn't it? Oh no. Or can you move through here? No, I think, yeah, you can go to the top here. Yeah, Arcade Classics, it's a bit of a letdown. Although, you know, what was this thing? I forgot. Like, it plays okay-ish. I like the Galaga version of that, kinda. You know, I didn't have better back then. The Galaxian is also kinda okay. The Ms. Pac-Man version is kind of eh. I mean, it works, but just not being able to see the full screen is kinda hurting that version. And there is some slowdown in that. What is interesting about that game, if I remember correctly, is that there is actually a two-player option, which is kinda cool. I'm not entirely sure if I ever actually beat this level here, so let's try it out. I think the time is actually very tight, and the flags, I think you actually need them all. I never actually played the NES version of Galaxian, so I can't really compare it much. In general, Galaxian isn't really my favorite game. I mean, it's okay, but it came out so close to Space Invaders. Like, in that point, I just enjoy Space Invaders more. And Galaga actually changed things up enough where it became such a different beast altogether, where I'm actually more inclined to enjoy it as its separate thing. But yeah, Galaxian, I'm just like, yeah, okay, maybe, but if I decide to play that, I would just rather play Space Invaders, because it's just a bit more involved. Where's the honking come from? I'm not sure what you which game you named there, because I didn't get that in the speech recognition there, which is me. But yeah, not sure what the PC made out of that. Well, I just don't know the game. I can't place it. That's very much possible too. And yeah, we're getting in some issues with time here. I'm afraid. Still need 3 flags as well. Is there more time left somewhere? Don't want the red thing, because that eats time. Yeah, I guess we need to go to the center. Can we make it? No, don't go there. Nope. I messed it up. And you only get 1 life. That is unfortunate. It's this is not my favorite game of the pack, as you might imagine. But you know, again, this was basically a demo disc, so in that case, it's okay. Captain Alphabet. Oh boy. About guys, if you for some hangman here, because that's basically what it is. This is. This is just such a lousy thing. Like, you can't even play with multiple people this. So putting this on a family game is kind of weird. And talk about stereotypes. What language would you select? Like, it doesn't even say it. It just like it comes across like, pick a character. And what you actually are doing here is picking a language. I'm actually, is it the English bloke? This is the Dutch bloke. This is the German bloke. This is, I assume, the French one, and this is the English one with the trilby hat. Yeah, this is a language select. You wouldn't know that because it looks like a character select, but nope. Every dude looks the same. Yeah, we got the trilby hat. let's see, what letter should we go for? I forgot which part of the screen is actually the selection? I don't remember. Is it the... Yeah, but I don't know where... Is it the top? Is it the bottom? I don't know. Let's try the top. Let's go for the E.
Go ahead.
Okay. Now, is there no E in it, or is it like at the anchor?
Go ahead.
Nope. At the bottom? B. Oh, okay. So the middle one is where you select it.
Go ahead.
And there is still no E. Great. Well, how about an A? There we go. Go ahead, yeah. They just it's just a quote from Dirty Harry, isn't it? Go ahead. let's see, what other vowels do we have? We have the U, but I suppose the O would make more sense. I'm not very good at hangman.
Go ahead.
O is not a good sign. How about you?
Go ahead.
I guess it's feeding time almost. I, there we go. Well, it ends with I and then possibly NG. Yeah, I think it's so as well. Oh, could also be... Wait, didn't I... Ah, there we go. How about chat? Gambling. Yeah, good one. I am so bad with these word games. There we go, gambling. Awesome. Thank you. Couldn't have done... Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Those sounds, man. Why? Why pick those sounds? Let's see. Context. Should we go? Yeah, of course. It's totally family. Should we go for a Dutch word or a German word or a French word? What do you say? I mean, probably a Dutch word I might figure out. And I'm not sure if Dutch, that Dutch dude is still watching as well, but... Dutch. Okay, let's do a Dutch... The pirate boy says, let's do a Dutch one. We can also try German after this one. Let's go for the Dutch one. And you'll see that the dude is still the same. I seem to remember that there was also the quote, make my day. But I don't think it's actually in here because he didn't see it. But probably just my connection with Dirty Harry. You know, just thinking of the wrong quote there. Let's go with an E. Yeah, there we go. And an E in Dutch is typically pronounced A or E. And let's go for the A, which in Dutch is usually pronounced A or A. Okay. Let's go for a N. Because that's usually a safe bet.
Go ahead.
Not this time, though. A S.
Go ahead.
No S. A T.
Go ahead.
Okay. Nope. Maybe I won't figure this one out. No T, no S. Should we try a D? Or should we try another vowel? Well, there's not many left. Okay. And I can't ask you guys now. There's no T. It would be funny if it's actually... A lot of Dutch vocabulary is actually English. And vice versa. So, you know, it might still be an English word anyway. But no, it can't be retail or a detail. Because there's no T. But let's try the R.
Go ahead.
Nope. Let's try the M. We're gonna sink, guys. We're gonna get eaten.
Go ahead.
Yep. I really don't know. Oh boy. Shall we try a J? Well, how would a J work? Well, we try. I mean, why not? Why not?
Go ahead.
Nope. an L? Did we? No, we did. So if I push a I here, yeah. Now I'm. Now the bell is nothing. What is this? What is this word? Derail. Yeah, but that's... Is that a Dutch word? Yeah, no, it's not. Again, detail. Didn't I push the T? Or did I misclick? It was the first word I thought about. I thought I hit the T right after the S. Oh my. Yeah, but again, like, detail is still English, right? There's so much. There's so much vocabulary that the languages share. Yeah, that was terrible. Oh my goodness, that's so annoying. I thought of detail, and I thought I pressed the... I picked the R, not the T. Ah, how stupid. Let's go for German one. Let's make it even harder. My German is not very good. Yeah, that's very possible. I mean, the T wasn't selected, otherwise we would have had it. Great, only four letters, huh? let's try an O.
Go ahead.
No, there is no O. So it's not shown. let's try an E.
Go ahead.
An A. An A. A. Two A's. Okay, sure. I don't know any German words that have two A's. Let's try an R. Germans like R's. What?
Go ahead.
Nope. Let's see. Has. Probably, maybe.
Go ahead.
Nope, not has. Sorry, Daniel, I didn't get your suggestion. Should we have a P?
Go ahead.
Sal? Ah, Sal. Yeah, it's kind of cool, you know, in Dutch it's almost the same, but not fully. We have Sal with a Z. But again, my German is just non-existent, pretty much. So I didn't know that was a thing. Awesome. Thanks, man. should we also try out the French version, or should we not endure that? Yeah, I didn't know any German words with... that have a double vowel. I don't know. Let's just move on, because I don't think we have any French people to help me out here. And clearly I needed it, because the only language I actually speak I couldn't figure out. Go figure. you know, it's a family game, so why not end a painting program? Wow, that's a lot of loading. And you can paint stuff, which I'm really bad at. And there's only a few colors. Is it 16 colors? Button 1, button 2. There's no actually wait, didn't it say draw and stamp? Oh, hello. Huh. How did I do that? Button 2, button 1, button 2. Is that how you move forward? Yeah, I guess. And okay. No, you cannot save work in this. So, you know, once you are done, you're done. This is the wipey wipe, yeah. Yep. We've got line tool, I guess. Yeah, cool. The bucket. Yep. And the stamp. You can put some stamps here. Here, man, eat a mushroom. You know, it's basic stuff. It's nothing special, but you know, as a family compilation, it's kind of neat for the kids. Don't really have much to say about it. How do we exit? No, that is, do it again. How do we exit? Oh, there, in the submenu, button 2. Okay. And then button 2 again. It's weird, some games have button 1 and the exit to confirm, and some have button 2. It's kind of odd. Super Slide, which is a sliding puzzle game, which is just bleh, but oh well. Lego Loco, I never heard of that one. But yeah, it's kind of, you know, a lot of early Windows 95 titles had stuff like that. Where you could customize some cards, print them out. And get into a huge fight with your parents on wasting way too much ink. it's a sliding puzzle, we don't need no practice, let's just challenge it. Time limit, let's go for 4 minutes, I suppose. Let's go. I'm really bad at sliding puzzles, so that 4 minutes is probably not enough for me. Oh dear. Yeah, Lego has a lot of games. Oh, there we go. That was really fast, how that went by. Let's see, what are the top parts? I already forgot what it looked like, go figure. this is top part, right? Or should we just start with the bottom, because that's... Yeah, that seems a bit easier. Where's the part that is here? Where is the bottom part? Yeah, I think this is the empty part. Right? Or this? That fits. Why? I picked all the games where I can embarrass myself the most, apparently. Which is, you know, it's part of the fun too, I suppose. Yeah, that looks okay-ish, right? Or not? No. Kinda like that better. But then where does this piece go? Like these three are in the bottom, that's for sure. I can't check out the picture one more time, huh? Hey there, Kensier. Great to see you. Thank you very much for dropping by, even though you're busy. Always cool. I hate this too. Let's. what do you say? We actually. Ooh, I got two together, but that's no way to go. I know that you should start at the top or the bottom and move your way up, but I kind of lost track what the bottom or the top is actually supposed to look like already. Let's move on to the next game. But yeah, really appreciate people dropping in and just checking out the stream, even though it's for just a moment. You know, it's always cool. And if you have any tips on how to improve it, always feel free to let me know, like something in the setup or something in the audio levels or video quality, because something in the video quality actually that kind of messes up things as well is the interlacing in CDI is kind of problematic now and then. Sometimes the retro works, sometimes the other way works. All right, and then we have this game is this sucks. This game is very hard and just very uninspired. Yeah, it's kind of weird, you know, these games. I agree, Austin. The game's having music and then not music, and it's just unfortunate. In these early games you have very little games that actually have music, and game sounds right away can actually, oh yeah, so in this game the controller actually does mean how fast you actually move. It's kind of interesting. And yeah, it's a shoot 'em up, but you know, it says clowns, which is never a good sign for most people. And when we are comparing it to Mystic Midway, this is far worse. Although, you know, this does come with a whole bunch of other games, so can't really fault it for that. Mystic Midway is, you know, also kind of basic, but also kind of a guilty pleasure, I must admit. Mystic Midway is kind of... Again, we have the return of the big... Ooh! Oh boy. Are you... Oh, okay. Phantom... It Came From the Desert is a Cinemassacre... No, not Cinemassacre, what is... Cinemaware, that's the one. Cinemaware game, isn't it? And yeah, that had the guy from Mystic Midway in there. Yeah, Mystic Midway is just good, quick fun. Yeah. Yeah, totally correct there, Austin. The Mystic Midway has two games, and the Phantom Express is kind of a depressing little piece of work. But yeah, rest in pieces, that thing is awesome. It's just good, quick fun. Can't kill the last guy, huh? There we go. Oh. Oh boy. I never actually see much of the videos of It Came From the Desert. I never actually played much of it, to be honest. It Came From the Desert also has this time limit mechanic, doesn't it? I mean, time limits always trip me up. Like, it makes me less interested in games when they've... you know, I just don't like that pressure. I don't function too well under pressure, so whenever a game is forced with a time limit, then usually I'm out. I'm just so bad with that. Whoa. I kind of love that I'm not sure if I've ever been here. But I kind of like FMV games for just the corniness and there's nonsensical plots and just their ridiculousness. It's usually It's usually just a good laugh, isn't it? And CDI has plenty of those. Although PC probably a bit more, just because of the sheer amount of... oh no, wasn't going to make it. Just the sheer amount of early adventure games using FMVs. Yeah, the return of the stock sounds there. But yeah, this is not a very inspired game, and I don't find it that much fun either. Yeah, it's just a very lazy stock sound inclusion here, and they're also crunchy too. It's a shame. Here's another ripoff you might recognize. This one has a story though. Doesn't it? Yeah.
Somewhere, just an hourglass twist ago, a fair maiden and knight were happily in love. Until a wizard promised the young knight power and wealth in exchange for the maiden's hand. The knight refused, and the angry wizard took away the princess. To regain his beloved, he must now face the wizard in a duel of dragon and ball.
I mean, don't you just get enthused right away with that delivery? I mean, there are oak boards more animated than that one. Anyway, what levels should we play? Let's try normal. Yeah. What game is this? What game is this? It is. Yeah, Dragon Balls. Pong. Like, wow, they really went for a lot of ideas. I mean, it's kind of different. Like, you have to destroy the walls and get your ball through there. But yes, it's just Pong. It's just Pong. And what's even more funnier is that there was a sequel to this game. Meaning family games. There was Family Games 2. And Family Games 2, of all the games, they figured, you know, that needs another go. They choose this, Pong. But yeah, we won. First win. Let's try hard. Because that wasn't very hard. I mean, it works well enough, but it's just Pong. And just adding a story to Pong, that's... Well, the thing with that dragon is, once the wizard wins, the dragon's loose, and it's gonna burn your bum. And you might think I'm joking, but... oh, boy. This is actually going faster. House of the Dragons got nothing on this story. Oh my goodness. And there we go. Burnt. House of the Dragons so far was pretty good. But that last episode, man, what the heck. But yeah, burnt up bum. It's kind of a mix of the two, isn't it? Breakout and Pong. But I still feel like it's mostly Pong because you go back and forth. And the final game, Hot Rocks, which is another stinker in my opinion. It's kind of funny because we recently, of course, had Thunder in Paradise. And this kind of plays like that shooter section of Thunder in Paradise, but it's so much worse. It's so much worse. And not fun at all. Anyway, we are protecting Earth from rocks. And that's basically it. Shoot the rocks and hold out as long as you can. And yeah, that moon, it's shooting rocks at us. Moon was finally fed up with Earth. Figured, you know, let's just get rid of the whole thing. And with button 2 you can actually change size. And you can only change side like one at a time. There is a set sequence. And like this, at this point I can't even see the bastards anymore because well, Africa is in the way, I suppose. they brown rocks mix in with the landmass. I'm not sure if this is actually Africa, come to think of it. But yeah, it's not fun. I'm not sure, one of the bars that are filling up, one is red, one is green, and one is representing your health, and one is representing Earth's health. And yeah, this is basically all there is, and I don't know, and it's so uninspired, there's no music here, it's just boring. It's just not great, there's nothing that's going to change up, there's no new levels, this is it. Moth blasters, I heard some things about, but you know, I think in the US that was actually quite common to see in elementary schools as an educational thing, but we didn't have much of that. We had some games, but not Moth Blasters, I suppose. I remember having in elementary school there was this cool apple, but I did not play any element or educational titles on there. I don't know what it was called. There was on the apple there was a game that where you also had to shoot asteroids, and there were two gates on either side of the screen that produced enemies. And there were mines, and I don't know, I haven't played this game in ages, but I kind of remember that, and it was so much fun. And yeah, I remember when you were done with your tasks in class, you could play with the game. And you know, you had you could play with the computer, but there was like the PC speaker, so you boot up some games, and it would blare through the classroom, and oh my goodness, you got big frowns. But you know, it's good if you can't see that stuff. But yeah, there were some educational titles we had at school, but not too many. Not too many, mostly typing things, come to think of it. And there was when we are talking about math, there was actually a title I do remember where you had to prepare for some marriage or something, and you had to row your boat, and I don't know, probably easy to find. Those things tend to be quite popular as nostalgia things, and it's probably more common. And I think if you mess up, like the groom got a pie in his face or something like that. It was more entertaining than a book, I tell you that much. And more entertaining than this game. I can even call it that. It's, yeah, I don't know, it's just... And even as you will see, once the... once we finally... mess up too much that we are done. Not really sure if you can even classify that as losing, but apparently it is losing. But even that, you know, it's so anticlimactic. Like you'd expect like the ship to blow up or the earth to blow up, but nah, nothing as bombastic. You'll see. We're almost there, luckily. And yeah, it's just a points collecting thing again, which you can't save again. I don't think it saves you game progress, at least. Actually, come to think of a bit about it now, I don't actually remember, because I don't, you know, I haven't played this game since I actually had a way to save games again. So I'm not sure. Maybe. Yeah, we're almost dead. Almost! Just a little while. Let's just let it go for now. And see how it goes. So, because I've had quite enough of this. It's not the best game. Instead, why don't you give me your opinion? Which game should we play now? Either Mega Maze or... Mutant Rampage Body Slam, which is actually going to be the game I am going to close off with. So we're going to play That for a bit. Let's see. Oh crap. Well, SB it is. She's my initials, I suppose. Mutant Rampage. Yeah, sounds like a good deal. This game with the mouse might be a bit better, but it's so boring. And this concept is just done so much better in Thunder in Paradise. And just coming off of that game, this one is just such a letdown. So yeah, Mutant Rampage, Body Slam. Let's go and have a actual pretty cool game here. I'm not gonna be great at it, because I'm very rusty in this one. I haven't played this one, I guess, since my review on the game. I did beat it then, but it's been a while. And yeah, this game does have animation from Animation Magic. I think it's quite a bit better than their Zelda and Hotel Mario games. But it doesn't mean it's amazing. But it's at least corny, so we can have a good laugh with it. No, but this is another game that I just need to redo. You know, it was more about the shits and giggles back then and just making fun of games than actually offering a good in-depth review, I find. But I don't know, I haven't seen it back in quite a while. I wasn't really super harsh on it. And you know, if you compare it to a Double Dragon, then yeah, of course it's no match. But for CDI, in the context of CDI games, it's kind of nice. But it is hard. you can. This is also kind of interesting because not a lot of CDI actually have a CDI titles actually have a options menu. But yeah, there's Wimpy, Savage, Insane. That's just a bit of Savage, I suppose. 3 lives. You can go up to 7. Okay, let's just keep it at 3 and see how we do. As I said, I want to make this the last game we go through anyway. Anyway, let's check out the intro here.
The year is 2068. Things have changed. The Millennium Wars ruined the world's cities. The Grey Tremor Plague of 2017 reduced the population by a third. Radiation from the Thanatos meltdown radically altered the gene pool.
It's a mutant!
Technology advanced. Bioengineers have created animal-human hybrids. Athletes are commonly enhanced with bionics. The Cybernet, a fiber optic communication network, links everything. The rage of the Cybernet is Body Slam.
Kind of funny how we move to the metaverse right now, isn't it? Maybe the game is kind of predicting our future. Anyway, we get to choose which area to go through first. And thank you very much, Daniel, for dropping by. Have a good night and see you next time. Thank you. Let's go to LA first.
This is El Wolf Jam with Body Slam. We got a new team on the block, the Naturals. Humans, not hybrid, not mutant, not bionic. Listen up while I turn them out. We got Damon Stone, quick with his fists and slick with his feet. Taurus Swift can kick, stick, flip, and sweep. She looks real good putting them down. Rack Saxon's big as an ox and strong. He's not fast, but he'll crush some bones. Petro Genocide, boss of the Cybermutes. What's your hit on these Naturals?
Humans are obsolete, Elwolf! These guys gotta have a death wish! It's looks like suicide!
Coming in clear, Hetro. All right, let's jam with Body Slam.
Hey there, Dennis. Great to see you on air. Thank you very much for joining us. I'm just quiet because of the cutscene here. Did he say that she can speak? Is that like a feat in the future? It's kind of weird. I don't know how these play anymore. Let's just go with this this stone here.
This is LA. We're ready to slam. We got the free radicals in a bout with the naturals. Slash Durham, boss of the free radicals. Got any plan for these naturals?
These humans think they know about pain. We've got something to teach them.
Yeah, I thought there was something still that he said in between. Quick on her feet, can speak or something. I thought, but, you know, have to look back. There's actually loading times. Not many CI have those, but yeah, here we go. And there's grappling when you get close to the enemies. And button one is just your punch. Button two is your kick or jump. But you know, attacking afterwards will actually make you kick. And it's... Oh crap. Those have a projectile. And you actually zip over the screen, which, you know, it's kind of weird how the momentum works like that. But yeah, enemies will eat through your health. And there is also a special which I totally wasted, and it will eat your health, of course. So, you know, it has all the markings of a beat-em-up, and it works well enough. It's not as fluid as something on the SNES or the Genesis, but kind of a given, I suppose. But it has awesome music from, indeed, Tony Trippi. I think Edward said Tony Trippi didn't get enough credit, and I totally agree. It's a cool rocking soundtrack here. He did a lot of cool music. The Zelda games, of course. I don't think he did the music for Hotel Mario. I'm not entirely sure now. But he did the music for Laser Lords. Yo, wake up, buddy. Don't wake up and punch me in the face. This also has, like, normally games have health items like a hamburger or something, and this just has alcohol and I think something is called crud. Kinda interesting way of, you know, playing with video game tropes. And this is the one thing that I do really like about this game, is that tag out line. You can actually tag out one of the other two characters here. And if I remember correctly, once you tag out a character, you will... Yeah, look at that deer on the floor. You will actually, as long as a character is in reserve, they will regain health. So that's real cool. Let's see if we can actually... tag in someone here. Let's go for Mrs. Swift here, or Miss Swift, I don't know. Here we go. Oh no, he went ahead. I think you can actually decapitate these dudes. What's that in another? Oh, wow. Did you eat my beer or drink my beer? You bastard. Yeah, so far she's being pummeled into submission. I don't think I like Tori Schwartz that much. There we go. Yeah, see, you can decapitate him. Yeah, there's only loading when loading in a different scene. Hey there, thank you very much for joining me, awesome. Zelda's Adventure was a classic, still. still brings in the views as well, I suppose. Ah, crap. I really need to redo Zelda's Adventure at some point as well, because that series just doesn't hold up that much. Is he called Stinky? I mean, he's farting on us, so it kind of makes sense. Yeah, this game is really long, because at the beginning we got to choose three areas. And oh my goodness, I'm really making a mess of things. And after you complete these three, after the three areas, you get to go to another three areas, and I think an additional three after that. So yeah, this game is really long and really tedious, and it does take a long while to actually beat. And it's fun in small bursts, I suppose. But to sit through the whole thing is kind of much, because, you know, for a CDI game it is great, but compared to other more fluid, beat-em-ups are just more fun to play. And yeah, I am very sorry about the stupid emoticons. I have no clue to shut those bloody things off. I try to. But they keep popping up. And yeah, as you can see, his life has been returned. Let's go for this dude. Sex on. And yeah, I don't know, man, but if this is a natural, you're telling me he didn't take anything? I mean, he pretty much looks like a mutant himself. Yeah, he's supposedly stronger, but usually stronger means so slow that you have trouble. I got issues getting in position with the fastest woman. Well, we're already dead almost again, so might as well switch out to preserve some health. Yeah, it's a good game. Dennis, the frames of animations are limited. Like, CDI is just very poor in general when it comes to sprites. Ah, crap. So, you know, they only can have so many different sprites per character. And as... wow, that guy was flying. As things are, it's honestly quite impressive to me how much characters they can animate on the screen at once. Oh yeah, these guys, or women, or whatever they are now. A favorite CDI game? I don't know. I really enjoy Hotel Mario in Short Birds. I know it's kind of a hot take. People seem to hate that game, but I find it's actually really good. It's my favorite though. It also really depends on what kind of mood you're in. Like, if you're with other people, there's a lot of good board games adaptations. Like, Master Labyrinth is kind of fun with other people. Yeah, and Seven Guests is surely an awesome game as well. Great rendition of that game. Yeah, I kind of hate it when people are hating on Hotel Mario just from seeing it, and basically, you know, they just see the cutscenes and that's it. It's a bad game, because why not? Why even try a game if you can just base your opinion on just one section of it? But it's actually, the gameplay is just fun. Although, funnily enough, might also not be a very original game, or it might just be coincidence, but there was a prototype for the Atari 2600 for a Bugs Bunny game that plays just like Hotel Mario. And I'm not sure if that was, if they knew that, but it just looks so similar in gameplay. Dennis, the golf games on CDI, I do have them, I played them, and I actually think that the golf open game, there's a couple of golf games actually, but the first one is actually quite good. Never played the second one, quite honestly. Also, the tennis game is quite decent. Has some good presentation, and for CDI, it's surprisingly well. And what I find interesting in the CDI golf game is that it forces you to really to become good and not just, you know, get used to all of the assists and just get through a game or course by that. And if you stick with it, you actually do see that you can get better at the game, at the golf game. And yeah, Hotel Mario is cool. Back in Worlds, I never played too much of it because, yeah, I agree, it's a very unfinished game and there's just not much game there. But what there is just looked really promising. And it's a shame that it never got finished. Who knows? Maybe someday we will find someone who can manage to reverse engineer it and actually make something out of it. Oh crap. Ah, that's the other game then. Yeah, I never actually put that one. It's kind of weird. You also have, should have taken the beer then. You also have a game like that for NHL. Yeah, that's the football league, right? I'm not much of a sports guy when it comes to American football or basketball, or hockey. So I always keep those, get those mixed up. I think it's NHL Hall of Fame, that's the history one. It's kind of a quiz game. And there's also one that is like a compilation of greatest hits or scenes or something, I don't know. I have neither, because honestly there's no interest for me in those. Maybe someday you pick them up in a pack or something. Will you stop that? I mean, smart that you don't date though. Oh man. We need another beer. Oh no, it's another stinky. We got stanked. Another problem with this game is that in the later levels, the enemies just get ridiculously tanky and almost all the same. The amount of variation just is lacking at certain point because you just see too much of the same thing. What kind of game would I like to remake the most for CDI? Let me think. It's kind of a good question. Well, I think I said that in my review as well, but I kind of like those. The other game that I have here, Mega Maze, is just a fun game that I think would do nicely as a redone indie title. Where you also have a level maker and such, that would be cool. Because it's a concept that's not seen too much still. Let's take the wine here. And someone did make the Zelda games. They made a pretty good remake of those, or a remaster. Ooh. Yeah, probably, maybe Austin. I just don't know anywhere it feels the same. And would be nice for Mega Maze to introduce some music, because that's the biggest flaw in that game. It's just such a silent game, which is a shame. Well, it's still full up, kinda. Famous lost words. And there's a beer here. Oh no, not stinky. Perhaps I should actually use my special more often, huh? Maybe just... Did he drink my beer again? Thank you very much for sticking around a bit, Dennis. Really cool to see you here, and have a good night and good luck tomorrow morning. 6 a.m. is way too early for me. So I don't envy you. Are we getting a new level here? Yeah, now we get to the actual boss of the stage. Finally, and he's beating my ass, of course. Let's switch out. I'm not actually sure if you waste a lost life if you switch to another character. So just let's go with the person who has the most life still. There we go. Oh wait, it's not the boss yet. It was just another... How many stages are there to one level? I guess this is, you know, the thing with this game too. Just the levels take on so long. Did she just go for all of my punches? Let's go here. And switch out again. And probably test that theory out soon enough. In having to select another character if you die, or having to redo the level. I don't know. We'll figure out soon. I definitely recommend, if you are serious about playing this game, just set difficulty lower and use like 7 lives per character. And yeah, the difficulty, the enemies don't get much more difficult in or easier in their actual movements and attacks. It's just basically their health that changes. And yeah, in the final levels, they become such sponges. It's just, it really gets very repetitive. Like, already it's getting kind of repetitive. Which is the downside of the game. It's cool for what it does. But the CI is just not capable enough to really give you enough variation for a game like this to work. And then it makes the cardinal sin of making a beat-em-up too long. Like, beat-em-ups are... What's gonna happen now? Beat-em-ups are, for a reason, like, short.
Knocked the socks off the naturals. Petro, you saw the fight. What's your analysis?
Humans are gonna get beat, Elwolf. These guys fight like some limp fish. It's like sickening.
The dude has a really he basically always says the same thing. Now we get to select another character. And basically have to do the same stage over again. Yeah, and what this game does have is presentation. I mean, it looks nice. And, you know, the music is pretty cool. Some cool music. But yeah, Streets of Rage you can easily go through in one sitting. And that's for a reason, you know. Even that game, if you play that for 2 hours straight, it's a bit repetitive, you know. Don't you drink my beer, buddy. Ah, crap. Yeah, a lot of the actual animation frames are just repeated and reused. And because it's animation magic, it just is so much more apparent. Because they have this exaggerated style of movement. Wow, it almost looks like I had skill there. Yeah, I think so too. He has double health. Oh. Extra life, just in time. There we go, and he's down to his final health bar. Wow. Yeah, that went better than I expected.
radicals are mutant wimps, Elwolf! Wait till the naturals face somebody tough!
I got murdered more times than I can remember there, so it's tough enough as it is. Who should we go to? He's just the wolf, he's just a showman, isn't he? He's doing it for the views, man. we're not actually going to see the boss of this, I'm pretty sure. let's go here. There's two more lives here, so let's go. There's also life does not refill.
It's an animal slam in old ruined Rome. Animalfa Roma is about to bite the naturals. Tina Felina, boss of Animalfa Roma, what's in store for the naturals?
I cannot wait to claw these naturals, especially this demon stone. He will bleed.
Just a hunch, guys, but I think this might be people's favorite. for kids. No, actually, I say that. But yeah, this is one of the first games I know of that actually has a age rating on the back of the case in Europe. Oh, we're going the other way now, aren't we? Yeah, before furries were a thing even. It was, well, they probably were. Yeah, it's just slightly sexualized. Jeez. And with the name Roma, I was actually expecting, you know, a big stereotype of the Roma, but nope. Just a cat lady. Just because we are in Rome, I think. What was this in Italy? I don't remember. Yeah, also makes sense that there is a forum sign there. Come here, you. No, not that way. Come here to where I can connect my fist into your face. So, you know, as you see now, we have different enemy types, completely different, which is cool. But after the first three levels and you have to select three more villains, then you will just get repeats. And, you know, it's just a shame, you don't get more variation. Those Romans, man, they knew how to build stuff. Survived quite a bit of quite a few wars, didn't it? yeah, let's eat the sandwich before they do. Get out of here, buddies. Yeah, guys, and if you have any suggestions for next time when we do a CDI stream for a game to play through, or partially, most likely, let's switch out. Then do let me know so I can prepare it for the next time. And put it aside. And also things that I might show off during these streams are, for example, more of the edutainment kind of things, which, you know, are kind of cool to have a laugh with, but not really interesting to make an actual review on. But there's some interesting stuff in that regard. There's some cool titles like that. And also some utter crap. Which, you know, are good for some good hilarity. Ouch. Yeah, just enjoying the music here. The Tony Trippi really knew how to work this, because this music is kind of interesting, because it's just... Oh man, I wanted to switch out. It's... it's melodic, but it's also not, you know, it's a good kind of repetition to have as background noise. Oh, we eat a live fish. Okay, of course, makes sense. Now we enter the sewers, I suppose. Yeah, again, some reviews I also want to do some more reviews of my older stuff, because a lot. Oh, it wasn't a fish. It was a fish. And yeah, this game I might do a new review of as well, because all my older stuff is I don't know, man, they don't hold up nicely. Some things do, but in all of them there is this giant beeping sound in the background. Not nice to listen to. And yeah, sometimes I see stuff on screen, but I don't really know. It's just my brain filling in some blanks. I see something moving, and it's gray, probably a fish, whatever. The stick actually does good work here. Get out of here, buddy. Oh, okay, so using the special when you hold something actually has you throw stuff. Kind of makes sense. I mean, other games do that too. Is there food in here? Yeah, there is some more alcohol. Some wine or something? I don't know. This is a mystery bottle, which is of course always safe to drink, especially those that you find in the sewer. And yeah, don't worry if you have no clue about the CI library, because that's of course also part of the fun here, where we just go through some games and show them off. Some more people need to learn about the CI, or well, must know, but you know. It's always, I find it always interesting to learn about a new system I'm not familiar with, and see how people go through that library of games and just learn new things. Like the Ginger MP Gaming recently did a nice video on the, what's the name now? Farchild Channel F, there we go. And that's a system I know about, but I've never played with it, because those things are really ridiculously hard. Oh, come on. They are so hard to find. So it'll be, it's always great to find new systems. And just see what they were like. And we're dead. It's the same scene now?
Ooh. Animorpharoma just slammed the jam out of the naturals. Petro, you saw the fight. What's your analysis?
Humans sure can't compete, Elwolf. These guys ought to get a psychologist. It's like insanity.
Laying on the insults there. But hey, a new kind of animation. Yeah, games are really getting ridiculously expensive now. It's a shame. I don't really pick up many games anymore. You know, I kind of got out of the thing a few years back. But nowadays prices are just insane, and that's unfortunate. Luckily, you know, it's getting easier and easier to play most games through emulation and such, so you know, you can still enjoy them. But CDI is one of those systems where that is kind of, ah crap, it's kind of different. Zelda's Adventure, I actually have two copies of Zelda's Adventure, and one was totally unintentional. One was intentional, where I was lucky, where I bought it early, and I saw it in the pack, and I just offered, I don't know, a couple of bucks for it, and the person just accepted it. Another time, I just bought another, well, that guy was flying again, I just bought another stack of games, and it was just in there, and the pictures did not show it. It was, one of the luckiest finds I ever had. Now, back then, Zelda's Adventure wasn't worth as much as they are now. But still. I made a video of that. I don't even remember that. But yeah, that was one of my luckiest finds, I suppose. Especially now when you look at that game. And it's not worth it, guys. It's not worth it. One thing that is good to note about CDI, if you have the system, there are most CDI games are dumped. And you can just burn it and play it on any CDI because there is no copy protection. Not all games are dumped though, that's kind of a bummer. And if you don't have a CDI, nowadays you are also kind of out of luck because those things tend to ask a hefty price now too, unfortunately. But yeah, don't buy Zelda's Adventure for 200 bucks, let alone 1000, like holy crap. Oh. Really, that didn't connect. I need food. Badly. Chicken! For the win. Or what's the ham? I don't know. Look more like a ham. And of course, if you can emulate some games on CDI, particularly those that do not use the DVC, the digital video cartridge, they tend to do alright. So, you know, just load up a... And that's also true, yeah, good call, Pirate Boy. Most games, whether you put it into an NTSC system or a PAL system, work. There's very few exceptions. The only one I can really think of now is Family Games 2, where you actually get some graphical errors. Yeah, the market has changed quite a bit, and it's really so, like, people start seeing it like an investment, and that's just so weird to me. These things need to be played, I think. If you want to invest in money, buy a Van Gogh or something, you know, or a nice Rembrandt. Please don't throw tomato juice at it, or soup. Who was this artist who recently also just destroyed his portrait to make NFTs of it? Like, what the heck? Art takes so many weird forms, man. But yeah, these video games, they are meant as entertainment, so let's please play them and not lock them up in cases. Oh no, flying enemies. Oh my goodness, flying enemies are always the worst in fighting games. Luckily they at least have the shadow here, but this is probably death. Yeah, this is not going well. Yeah, we're dead. Yeah, I still have another life. Kind of funny, the special actually changes because the kick was also the special. It must be if you have not enough life. Oh my god. Really? Well, that might kind of make sense, Ed, because they didn't do any action group any good, did they? They lost any sympathy. It's kind of weird if you go about setting your message by destroying property. Oh well. And we are dead indeed. Yeah, that thing is trouble. Shame it's so far up. I don't think that was actually the final boss.
Animorph aroma just slammed the jam out of the naturals. Tina Lena Felina, did the Naturals give you a good fight?
A good fight? No. But the feel of claws ripping flesh. It is very nice.
Yeah, it doesn't sound surprising, you know. It sounds like a very stupid thing to do. But, oh well, not everyone apparently knows how to think. and yeah, you get sent back, so, you know, if you play this game and you want to play the... Would pet? I don't know pet enough to actually... But yeah, it sends you back to the menu and you have to start all the way back. So if you want to complete the game, just set it on easy and set it on next lives and you might be fine. And maybe if you can actually get good at it, it's doable, but phew, it gets tedious fast. Yeah, but there was no DeviantArt yet, was there? Anyway, I think I want to close it off just a bit because I'm getting quite tired already and we've been at it for quite a while, almost 3 hours, holy crap. It's a bit long. But yeah, next time we will explore some more games. And maybe we will play through Mutant Rampage at some point in full and actually see all the zany cutscenes. But yeah, then I will probably play it on easy. And yeah, thank you very much, man, for joining me on this stream. It was really cool to have you guys here once again. It's just, you know, really great how this is going. And Rater Roadshow, cool to see you in here, man. Thank you very much. Sorry, we're almost already closing down because it's actually almost 11 now here, and I don't want to go on too long because, you know, the people below me, they might not approve. But yeah, really great to hear that you guys had fun. If you have suggestions for another time, then do let me know and we'll prepare some more CDI titles next times. Because yeah, there's a lot of CDI games. So if you want Sunday, I will try to go for the Commodore again and test some more tapes, which is also fun. And I will try to make this also a weekly thing on Wednesday, I suppose, where we can just go for some CDI stuff. And yeah, I'm sorry things are still a bit rusty. I'm still learning how to make things actually work properly, but you know, we'll get there eventually. And this time I was also lucky because Grisha was being a good kitty this time around, wasn't he? Hey buddy, you slept through the whole thing. So yeah, once again, thank you all very much for joining me, and yeah, it's great to hear that you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you guys next time. And until then, take care. For now, I will say the muzzle.